LEGO Pirates of the Caribbean Collectibles walkthrough, and by collectibles I mean Minikit walkthrough for the Isla Cruces level, which is level 5 of the first movie. And you should know by now that the first movie is The Curse of the Black Pearl. But anyway, the first one, you just need to use an explosive character to get in the boat and walk on, or ride on, row on over to that Minikit to the right. The other one is, or the second one will be here when you need to use Jack to jump over one side, and then the girl to jump over the other side. You just have to jump onto this and then super jump, or probably even normal jump, onto that Minikit. The third one involves collecting parrots, and one of the parrot stands is at the beginning, but and the last two are near the end. I actually missed the one in the beginning, so I got the last two before the first one, but there was one kind of in that rocky area. I think that was after you defeated the Black Pearl minions. And the second one is near that wall, and the first one, I guess the third one would be near the wall. Anyway, the final one for me was over here by this lamp, which is all the way near the beginning of the level. Now, for these last set, by last set I mean these last 7 minikits, they are really they're so annoying to find. They're seriously the worst minikits I think I've ever had to find in a LEGO game, just for the difficulty of them. And I know this is a LEGO game, it's not that hard, but even for LEGO standards, this was ridiculously hard. So anyway, you just need to, when you're fighting Barbossa, you need to use Serena to break open the cave and then bust this shining chest open, and there will be a guy who wants a telescope. But to get the telescope, you need to come back out and walk all the way to the left to once again use Serena, and make sure that you get Barbossa down to, I think, 2 hearts before you do this, either 3 or 2 hearts. And just fight Barbossa until this opens up. And once that opens up, use Serena to break it open. Now here, you have to use Jack's compass, but the only way that Jack can use his compass is if he is the Cursed Jack. And you have to buy the Cursed Jack in the hub, which is kind of annoying, and I'll explain how that works. Basically, you need to beat this level once, go into the hub, and not play as Jack. Play as someone else other than Jack, and make sure the person following you also isn't Jack. And then walk out of the very first area of the docks, and then walk back in, and Curse Jack should be somewhere wandering around there. It's really annoying, really stupid, but hey, you need to do it. And yeah. So anyway, when I was ranting on about that problem, you just need to take the telescope back to the soldier, and he will give you the minikit. This one involves matching colors for the first time, and then mixing colors for the second time. I speed it up in a second though, but here, as you can see, just put the 2 red eyes in front of the red box. And it's kind of hard to see because the lighting is terrible. Even my brother, like, I'm colorblind, as some of you probably know, but my brother isn't. He could hardly see what the heck these colors... were. So I don't know, it was just bad design on whoever made this part. So anyway, here's the yellow box, and push the 2 things in, then move the yellow eyes, push the 2 things in, the coffins, and here it's green, which I think is yellow, and what the heck is the color green mixed to, Scar? What makes green?
Yellow and blue.
Yellow and blue, okay. Yeah, I'm terrible with colors. Then there's purple, which is yellow and, no, which is blue and red. And then there's orange, which is yellow and red. And once you do that very annoying sequence of events, you will get the minikit. The next one is thankfully not as stupid as the last two, and all you have to do is walk over to the left of those boxes, use Jack's compass to find this golden dog, and then use a girl to super jump onto the rope that is hanging above there, which you can barely see in the top of your screen. Then the dog will be happy you've seen sunlight for the first time in 6,000 years, and then you'll be able to jump down and pick up the minikit. The next one is back where you found the telescope, and you have to use Jack's compass once again with Curse Jack to find the golden helmet to put on that statue over there, because he is very unhappy without his hat. And they make you walk all the way over here, and then they make you pick it up, and of course it's something you have to carry, so you walk very slowly. And once you finally get that over to the statue, he will throw out the minikit by doing absolutely nothing. And to the left of the statue, there's this kind of hard to see, like, I wouldn't think that was a tunnel if I didn't look twice, but anyway, there's a tunnel there, and you just have to use Jack's compass to find this clam that is over to the left. And you actually don't have to use this compass, but it is good to guide you through the very hard to see through water. And then you're gonna need someone who can walk on water, walk on the seafloor, and has super strength. I'll put the code up for him here in case you don't want to find him in the hub. And just pull open the clam, and there he is. Or there's the minikit, I mean. For this one, come up above the clam, jump onto the dock, and use someone with a projectile. I just use William, because he's easy. He's easier to control, I think. And shoot down that net on the ship. And right here is really annoying to try and get. I don't know why this was so difficult, but you kind of have to jump on top of here, then jump onto this captain's deck area, and then jump onto that second one, and then jump onto this chain, which may take you a couple of tries, because I fell off like 15 times trying to grab that stupid chain. And there's the ninth minikit. Now for the last one in this wretched level, all you have to do is come over to the right of the docks with Blackbeard, open up the chest, build the cannon, and very conveniently there's a torch right there. So pick up the torch, fire the cannon, and shoot the ducks. After you shoot the ducks, you will be able to find the 10th minikit.